Welcome to session one. Remember, sitting for long hours hampers your joint mobility, leads to stiffness in your muscles, and which could result into injuries. This pack has been designed to restore the flexibility of your joints and the stability of your muscles. So let's get started. The first movement today is the bird dog. Watch the technique and listen to my instructions carefully, and then we are going to do it together. You get down on your all fours, your arms in line with the shoulder, quads in line with the hips. Post that, you push your arms out, push the right arm out and the left leg out. Suck the pelvic in, biceps close to the ear. You hold it here for a while and then get the knees close to the elbow. You push it out again and hold it for a while. We are going to do this for 25 seconds on each side. Ready to start? Let's go. Hold it there for a while and get knee to the elbow. Back. Hold it there for a while. Remember, you have to suck your abs in and back. 10 seconds over. Suck the abs in and back. Hold it there for a little more. Knee to elbow and back. Right, 5 more seconds. Keep holding it and switch. Knee to elbow, back. This movement is going to stabilize your spine. It helps to correct your posture and make your core overall much more stronger. Remember, you have to hold it in that position for about 2 to 3 seconds before you get your knee to the elbow. Another 5 seconds, you can do one more rep. All right, done. The second movement is lateral hip openers. You stand with your feet wider than your shoulders, toes pointing straight. You lean to your right side, bending your right knee, keeping the left leg straight. You switch to leaning to the left side from there. And you move back and forth between right and left, and we do this for 50 seconds. Ready to start? Let's go. To the right and left. We'll do it for 50 seconds. Right and left. Remember, you got to keep the right leg straight when you are bending to the left side. To the right and left. Sitting for long hours, make your hip flexors very tight. This movement is going to open up your hip flexors and making your day-to-day movements much more smooth. Let's go, come on. Keep going. To the left and right. Remember to keep your back straight while you do that. Yep, you're doing good. If you bend it a little more, if you have a better range of motion, it is also going to work on the flexibility of your ankles. 5 more seconds. All right, you can do one more rep. And time. The third movement is high knees. You start with your feet in line with your shoulders and get your knees to chest, one at a time. You can start slow, but after some time, you start using your hands as if you're running. Imagine that you're running and use your hands that way. We will do this for 50 seconds. Ready to start? Let's go. Start slow, start slow. It's all right. It's okay to start slow. This workout is going to increase your heart rate. Keep going, keep going. Get your knees as high as possible. Knees to chest. In another few seconds, we'll make it a bit faster. Let's go, make it fast. Start using your hands. Imagine that you're running in the ground. Keep going. Good job. This is getting your heart rate higher. It works on your stamina and your endurance. Keep going. Knees to chest a little higher and keep using your hands at the same time. Come on, keep going. You're doing good. Few more seconds. Keep going. Don't give up now. Keep your abs tight. Another 3 seconds. And we are done. The fourth movement is the Superman. You lie down flat on the ground. Raise your legs and chest at the same time. Your biceps will be in line with your ear. You do this and then get back on the ground. Raise back up and down. Remember not to get your hands flat on the ground while doing this movement. But if you think it's too difficult for you, you can rest and get back up again. Ready to start? Let's go. We'll do this for 50 seconds. And down, back up, and down. This movement activates your core. Remember, your core is not just your abdominal muscles. It also includes your glutes and your back. Keep going. You must be feeling the pain in your lower back, but that's okay. It's just making you stronger. Remember not to touch your hands back on the ground, but if it's too difficult for you, you can go rest for a while and come back up. But eventually, you have to start doing it without any rest. Come on, you're doing good. Come on, keep going. Don't give up now. You must be feeling the pain in your lower back, but that's not the pain, that's just making you stronger. Another 2 seconds, and we are done. Round two, movement one, bird dog. Get down on all fours and let's start the movement 25 seconds on each side. Let's start. Getting the knee to elbow and pushing both the limbs out again. You hold it there for a while. And remember to keep those abs tight, keep it sucked in. Keep going. You're doing good. Remember, you have to suck your abs in, keeping that back straight, stabilizing your spine. Another 3 seconds and then we switch sides. All right, switch. Left hand up and right leg up. Knee to elbow and back. You hold there for a while and then knee to elbow again. Keeping the back straight, keeping the abs sucked in. Another 5 seconds. And done. The second movement is lateral hip openers. Let's get straight into the movement and we will do it for 50 seconds. Ready to start? Let's go. Keep your back straight. Try to keep it straight as much as you can. Try to go a little deeper now as it's the second round. It'll also work on your ankle flexibility. Keep going. You're doing good. You feel the hip flexors opening already, I'm sure. Good job. Try to keep your back straight. Try to keep that spine straight. Keep your abs tight. Performing these movements help you to perform much more complex movement a little later in time. This is how you start. Another 3 seconds. And we are done. Movement three, high knees. We'll do this for 50 seconds. Remember, you start slow and then you pick up speed a little later. Ready to start? Let's go. You start slow, getting your knees to your hands, and then you start the speed. Let's get faster now. Since you're already warmed up, it's okay to push yourself a little bit. I want you to get your heart rate a little higher. I want you to really push yourself in this workout. Make it a little more faster. Imagine that you're sprinting. Come on. Keep going, keep your abs tight. In any movement, remember, you have to activate your core. Keep going and keep breathing. Control the breathing, keep it slow. Take a deep breath, hold it for a while and then release it. It's gonna make you hold a little longer. You're doing very good. Come on, keep going. 5 more seconds, don't give up now. Keep going. And done. The next movement is Superman. You lie down on the ground on your chest, keeping the arms out straight. Raise your legs and hands at the same time. We'll do this together for 50 seconds. Ready to start? Let's go. And down. Without touching the hands back on the ground, go back up. You can also make a fist to look like Superman. Keep going. Making your lower back much more stronger. Also working on your hamstrings, your glutes, pretty much your entire body. This is one very good workout which is going to activate your core like no other workout. Keep going. Try to lift a little more higher now, your lower body and your upper body both. Your legs and your chest, try to lift a little more higher. In another 5 seconds, we'll be done. and time. Round 3, movement 1, bird dog. Let's get down on all fours and start the movement. We will do this together for 50 seconds, 25 seconds on each side. Remember to hold it when your hand and legs are pushed out. Remember to hold it for a while. And then get your knee to elbow. The strength of your spine is very important. It stabilizes any other complex movement that you're trying to do. It'll also help you to sit for those longer hours at work. In another 5 seconds, we switch to the other side. And switch. Remember to suck those abs in. Keep the back straight. It also corrects your posture. Keep going and hold it. Knee to elbow and back. Hold it for a while and back. Another 5 seconds and we'll be done. Time. Movement 2, lateral hip openers. We will do this for 50 seconds. Let's start. To the right and then to the left. Remember to keep your left knee straight when your right is bent. Keep going. Keep your back straight. It works on opening your hip flexors. You're doing good. Try to go a little bit deeper if you can. Keep going. Keep your abs tight. Five more seconds and we will be done. And done. Movement 3, high knees. We start slow and gradually pick up the speed. Let's start, 50 seconds. Start slow, keep a target, keep your hands up so that you can reach with your knees to your hands. And start picking up the speed. Imagine that you're sprinting. Make it count, make it a little faster. Keep going. It's just the last round. I want you to push yourself now. A little more faster. And keep your hands moving at the same time. Keep breathing. Do not hold your breath. This movement also works on making your legs stronger. It works on improving your speed. Keep going. You're doing good. Keep using your hands. Do not slow down. It's just the last round and last few seconds of this movement. Another 5 seconds, a little faster, and done. Movement 4, Superman. Get down on the ground, stretch your arms out, and let's do this for 50 seconds. Let's go. And down, up, lift a little more, and down. A little more, good job. Keep going, keep that pace. You must already be feeling a little bit stronger. A little tighter on your lower back, but that's completely fine. It's just making you stronger. Up, a little more, and down. Good job, keep going. This movement is engaging the whole of your back muscles, your hamstrings, your calves, your glutes, and making it overall much more stabilized. 5 more seconds, and we are done.
Good job there. Now these movements really helped activate your core, activate your glutes, strengthen your back, and also build your stamina. A total body workout.
So do not stop moving. We will see you in session 2.